Eddie Murphy here, and I'm a gambling fool. Welcome to the Essany Theater. I'm glad you're here for Ivy House production of One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. Now let's have some fun.
Mr. McMurphy.
Yes, Miss Ratchet.
There are rules we must follow.
Yes, Miss Ratchet.
In the unlikely event of an emergency, exits are to your right through the curtains. Do not go to your left. You'll run into a brick wall, and if you do that, I may just think you're cuckoo. Please do not use your cell phone during the performance. Please turn your phone completely off. The phones interfere with our microphones, and that would make me unhappy.
Hell, we don't want that.
Mr. McMurphy, I'm talking. IPAL is supported in part by a grant from the Louisiana State Arts Council through the Louisiana Division of the Arts and the National Endowment of the Arts, as administered by the Acadiana Center for the Arts.
Whew! Well, that was a lot of useful information from the big nurse. Now let's have a few laughs. It's finally time for Broadway on the Bayou.
Down below the ground. They're putting people in one end, and out comes what they want. The way they do it, Pop. Each night they tip the world on its side, and everybody loose goes rattling to the bottom. Then they hook them up by the heels, and they hang them up, cut them open. Only by that time, they got no wings. Just some busted up gears and stuff. And all they bleed is rust. You think I'm raving, because it sounds too awful to be true. But, oh my God, there are so many things that are true. Even if they never really happen.
Well, well, if it isn't the chief.
The super chief.
Oh, deaf and dumb.
Had his breakfast and ready to go.
Don't you know better? Don't you know to say to that roach that bell rings? Look at him shagging. He's big enough to eat an apple off of my head. He's still scared like a baby.
Oh, man. What's the matter, baby? Your broom? That's it. He won his broom.
Oh, gee, Brum, that's it. That's a good loony.
Start sweeping, baby.
Oh, Brum, Brum.
Oh, Chief Brum.
If you don't mind, boys, I don't think it wise to group up and stand around like that. Mean on Monday morning, you know. Such a lot to get done.
Yes, Miss Ratchet.
Warren, why don't you start by getting poor Mr. Bronwyn shaved? Williams, you have dormitory duty, don't you?
Yeah, Miss Ratchet.
That's just fine, boys. That's okay. Let's just get started, okay? Medication time. All patients to the day room. Medication time.
you sure? Dear Lord, for the tranquility we are about to receive, we thank thee.
Billy, dear, I spoke to your mother last night. Billy, I had to tell her.
What did you say?
That you were very sorry and you promised not to try it again.
Thank you, Mr. Cratchit.
Drink it all, dear. Good morning, Mr. Scanlon. Mr. Cheswick.
Now, wait a second, honey. What are these?
Medication.
Christ, I can see that, but what kind?
Just take it, Mr. Cheswick, please, just for me.
Don't give me that crap! All I want to know, for the love of God, is...
It's all right, Charles.
What do you mean?
You don't have to take them.
That's what I'm saying! You just throw any kind of shit at a man and you expect him to...
I don't. Well, that's okay then.
Good morning, Mr. Martini.
Morning.
Mr. Ruckley. Williams, we have a new admission today. I'd like you to meet him at receiving. Nurse Flynn, I'll be in the staff room. Behave yourself, boys.
Behave yourself, boys. But we have a choice.
Hey, come back here, you Indian. Hey, I can't say I like the look of that eye. Yeah, that's better. Look out there!
Did you take him out, Mr. Scanlon?
Say, honey, do you need some help?
I don't need anything.
Your deal, Martini.
Huh? Oh, yeah. Okay. Here we go.
Hey, knock it out.
What's the matter?
There's nobody there.
You sure?
There's four of us.
Okay.
Will you, for God's sake, stop hallucinating? Oh, give me the cards.
What's funny?
That mousy little nurse, she reminds me of the first time I saw a girl take off her clothes. I was 8 years old, you see, and I climbed up a tree so I could look down at her bedroom window. By the time she got to her little panties, I got so excited I fell out of the freaking tree. That's it, Billy. Write it down.
We're supposed to.
Sure, Billy, get a gold star.
Hey, you write down everything I say.
Right, and I'm gonna write down some things you did.
Oh, shut up, you two.
Fuck them all.
This place is a madhouse. Fellow psychopaths, as president of the Patients' Council, I, Dale Harding, do hereby decree 10 seconds of blessed, therapeutic silence.
Oh, wait, you're so wrong! I don't have to do this, and I don't have to do that, and you get the hell away from me before I...
Well...
Hey, good morning, buddy. It's a mighty nice fall day.
Damn, what a sorry-looking bunch.
Now, see here, mister.
Oh, hey, leave me alone, boy. Give me a minute to look over my new home, will you? What the hell? I never been in an institute of psychology before. Hey, that's better. Hey, my name's McMurphy, but he's R.P. McMurphy, and I'm a gambling fool. What's this game you're playing here, huh? Pinochle? Jesus! Ain't you guys got a straight deck? Well, see here, I brought my own, just in case, eh? Check out those cards, boys, huh? Every card a picture, boys. Every card a picture.
Hey, 52 positions, each one of them different.
Hey, easy now, easy now.
Hey, don't smudge them.
We got lots of time, lots of games. You see, what happened was I got myself in a little hassle down on the court farm, see? And the court ruled I'm a psychopath. You think I'm gonna argue with the court? Oh boy, you bet your bottom dollar I don't. Not if it gets me out of work in them damn pea fields. I'll be whatever that little heart desires, whether it be a psychopath or a mad dog or a werewolf. Because as long as I don't have to pick up another weed hoe, it's my dying day. And when you get the fuck away from me!
Look here, mister. We got rules here. I gotta take your temperature and I gotta get you showered.
Nah, the only thing you gotta do is let me get acquainted with my new buddies here, huh?
You knew one more thing!
All right, fella. You asking for it. You're gonna get it.
That's better now, huh? That's better. Now we can get a few things set. Which one of you is the bull goose loon? I'm asking, which one of you is the bull goose loon?
I'm not the bull goose loon. Although you could say I'm next in line for the job.
Well, I'm real happy, buddy, that you're next in line for the job, but since I'm thinking about taking over this whole shebang, maybe you ought to take me to your leader.
Mr. Harding, you president of patient's council.
Does this gentleman have an appointment?
Do you have an appointment, Mr. Harding's a very busy man.
This busy man, Harding, he the bull goose loony?
That's right.
Well, you tell bull goose loony Harding that R.P. McMurphy wishes to see him. And that this madhouse ain't big enough for the two of us. You tell him, unless he meets me man to man, that he ain't nothing but a yellow skunk.
And he better be out of town by sunset.
Billy, you tell this young upstart, Mr. McMurphy, that I'll meet him in the main hall at high noon and we'll settle this affair once and for all with libidos ablazing.
You tell him, Billy, that R.P. McMurphy is used to being the top man in every situation, and that if he used to be a loon, then he aims to be the knockdown, stomp-down, daggone biggest one of all. There, by God, and we ain't spilled a drop of blood. Now, introduce me to the rest of the fellas.
Well, on this side of the room, we're the acutes.
Oh, what's acute about you?
It means we're presumably curable. Over there, the chronics, a dancer and a vegetable.
And they ain't curable? What the hell? Yeah. Hey, buddy, R.P. McMurphy. Okay. Hey, Randall P. McMurphy.
You got any cigarettes?
Nothing but. Get it? Hey, buddy.
Careful!
Hey, what's that you're working on there?
It's a bomb. To blow up the whole stinking world.
Buddy, you got competition. Hiya, buddy. Excuse me, pal. Hiya, buddy. It pains me to see any man sloshing around in his own water. So, why don't you go get dried up?
Pull the nails out.
The what? Oh, okay.
Fuck them all.
Jesus Christ.
Hoo-wee!
What do we have here?
That's Chief Bromden.
Hey, what's your story, Big Chief?
He can't hear you. He's deaf and dumb.
Really? So, what they got him strapped down like that for, huh? I don't like that one bit. Hey, this just ain't dignified. Say, you get your full growth, you would be some good size. Hey, what tribe is it?
Well, I don't know. He was here when I came.
According to the doctor, he's a Columbia River Indian, one of those who lived up in the waterfalls, but I do believe the tribe is now defunct.
A true chief? You defunct?
Mr. McMurphy?
Howdy, ma'am.
I'll take that.
Yes, ma'am.
Abe Williams tells me that you're being difficult.
Me?
Oh. I understand you refuse to take your admission shower.
Well, after that, ma'am, they showered me last night at the courthouse, and then they gave it to jail, and I swear they'd have scrubbed the ears right off of me if they could have found the facilities on the way over here.
That's quite amusing, Mr. McMurphy, but you must understand that our policies are engineered for your benefit, which means cooperation.
Ma'am, I'll cooperate from hell to Thursday. But you wouldn't want me to be impolite, huh? I had to get acquainted with all my new buddies.
Please understand, I do appreciate the way that you've taken it upon yourself to orient with the other patients, but everything that's on time, you must follow the rules.
You know, ma'am, that's the same thing somebody's always telling me about the rules. Right when I'm thinking about breaking every one of them. Hey, bomb boy, come on. Hey, let's throw some cards, huh?
With controls. They got wires running to each man and units planted in our heads. They got magnets in the floor so we only walk the way they want us to. We got stone brains, cast iron guts, and copper, where they took away our nerves. We got cogwheels in our bellies and a welding grid. And every time they throw a switch, they turn us on or off. They got a network clear across the land. Factories like this one for fixing up mistakes they made outside. The Combine. Pop. Big. Big. Big! Oh yes, there is two such a thing. They got me way back ago. The way they got to you.
Hey ya! Come on, suckers! You're hitting your sin! Hit you say! Well. And when the little lady's showing, the boy wants a hit. What do you know? Head coming at ya! Crewman, so sad. A little lady for the lad. And he's over the wall and down the road. Up the hill and dropped his load. Coming at you, Mr. Scanlon. And I wish some asshole
this hothouse for turning down the ever-loving music. Hoo-wee! I never heard such a driving racket in all my life.
Yes?
Would you mind switching off the goddamn noise?
Yes, Mr. McMurphy.
Yes, what?
Yes, I would mind. Music is considered therapeutic.
What in the hell is therapeutic about Lawrence Welk?
Please don't lean on the glass. It causes finger marks.
Horse manure!
Oh, Mr. McMurphy, I should mention that we have a rule against gambling.
We're just playing for cigarettes.
Are you sure those cigarettes don't represent something else?
Sure, a hell of a lot of smoke. Hey, you girls ought to laugh it up a little. But you know, that's some good thing she just brought up, huh? Maybe we ought to sweeten this game.
Where would we get the money?
Money? Stop, fool! Huh? I did a little checking before I got sent over here, see? And I know that damn near half you boys pull compensation every month. $300-$400. And it don't draw nothing but dust. So all you gotta do is, sign a few IOUs.
All right with me.
Let's say, each cigarette's worth a quarter. Huh? Run 'em! All right, boys, now we got a game.
Remember, Mr. McMurphy, no gambling for money.
Say, is that a two-way system?
No, but Miss Ratchet is a human radio.
Oh, she is, huh? Well, maybe I ought to just pull her plug. All right, Professor, with a due showing, here's a pack of Marlboros that says you fold. What's that? What is that?
Group meeting. Time for group meeting.
Group therapy. Every day at this time.
Okay. Every day, huh?
Martini.
Mr. McMurphy, would you like to join us?
Yes, ma'am.
Now then. Who would like to begin?
I guess I ought to talk about this. It was on account of my mother. Every time she comes visit me, it just leaves me feeling awful.
Your mother loves you, Billy.
I know. That's the trouble. I say to her, Mama, I'm not right in the head. I can't even talk straight. She goes right on. And then pretty soon I just want to kill myself. So I try.
Is it possible that you may be trying to punish her?
Sure it's possible. Miss Ratchet, could we talk about somebody else today?
You really ought to face it, Billy. Very well. At the close of Friday's meeting, we were discussing Mr. Harding's young wife. The fact that she is extremely well endowed in the bosom. Would anyone like to touch upon this further?
Touch upon what?
The subject.
Oh, I thought you meant touch upon her.
To continue. According to notes entered by various patients in the logbook. Oh, good afternoon, Doctor.
Sorry.
Yes, we were talking about Mr. Harding's relations with his wife.
Wife? Oh, yeah. I see her.
Where?
Ooh. Mami, una papón, la facura, tunadea, mafa, alungara. Sit down.
God, what wouldn't you for that man's eyes?
McMurphy, Randall Patrick. Committed by the state for diagnosis and possible treatment. 35 years old, never married. A history of drunkenness, assault and battery, disturbing the peace, repeated gambling, and one arrest for rape.
Statutory.
With a child of 15.
She said she was 17 and she was plenty willing.
A court doctor's examination of the child.
Doc, she was so willing, I took the padlock in my pants.
Our new mission doctor.
Seems you have no previous history. Any time spent in other institutions?
Does that include state and county coolest stuff?
Mental institutions.
No, this is my first trip. But I am crazy, Doc. I swear. Hey, look, let me show you. How did that little doctor down on the work form, how did he put it? Repeated outbreaks of passion that suggest possible diagnosis of psychopath. What he explained to Doc is a psychopath means that I fight and I fuck. I'm overzealous in my sexual relations. Is that real serious, Doc? You ever been troubled by it?
No, Mr. Murphy, I'll admit that I haven't.
Yeah, Doc, that part about fight, I can understand. But who ever heard of a man getting too much poo? Too much poozle.
I am interested in this statement. Don't overlook the fact that this man might be feigning psychosis to escape the drudgery of the work form. Well, Mr. McMurphy, what about that?
Do I look like a sane man to you, Doc?
Perhaps, Doctor, you should advise Mr. McMurphy upon the protocol of these meetings?
Yes, one of the first rules is that the patients remain seated.
Why, sure, Doc, sure.
You see, we operate on the theory of the therapeutic community.
Which?
Therapeutic community. That means that this ward is society in miniature, and since society decides who's sane and who isn't, you must measure up. Our goal here is a completely democratic ward governed by the patients, working to restore you to the outside. The important thing is that nothing fester inside you. Talk and discuss, confess. If you hear another patient say something of significance, write it down in the logbook for all to see. You know what this procedure is called?
Yeah, squealing.
Group therapy. Help yourself and your friends probe the secrets of the subconscious. Bring those old hidden guilts out to the open.
What guilts?
You have them or you wouldn't be here.
Yeah, I think I'm starting to catch on, Doc.
Excellent.
It's like this dream I had the other night. Maybe you could tell me what it means, huh? See, it was like me in the dream, only it wasn't me. It was more like somebody who looked like me, in the dream, that is. Somebody like my dad.
Yeah. Interesting.
Yeah, that's it for sure. It was my dad. Yeah, because when I saw him in the dream, that is, he had a big iron bolt ran right through his jawbone, just like old daddy used to have.
Your father had an iron bolt through his jawbone?
Yeah, a regular Frankenstein!
How fascinating. I don't think I've ever...
If I may suggest, Doctor, perhaps Mr. McMurphy might learn best by example. According to notes entered by various patients in the logbook, Mr. Harding has stated that he is very uneasy when walking down the street with his young wife because of the manner in which other men stare at her. He has further said, and I quote,
"She damn well gives them reason to stare," unquote.
Yes, sexual attention elsewhere. What reason, Dale?
Oh, I guess you could say that I haven't been notably ardent.
Do you mean sexually inadequate?
Maybe she's just plain too hot for him. Is that it, Harding?
Oh, I'll bet he's afraid of her.
Not afraid.
Okay, scared.
I guess it'd be fair to say intimidated.
It's the same thing.
I see Mr. Harding stated that his wife's ample bosom gives him a feeling of inferiority.
So why does he marry a broad with such big knockers to begin with?
I bet he's got a mother fixation.
I bet he was never weaned.
That's not it. I wanted a womanly woman. One who wouldn't compete, but who would help me to...
She has commented, Dale, that she finds you less than masculine.
Like the way you use your hands?
How about it, Harding?
You chose a woman who was quite obvious you're inferior. Don't you find significance in that?
Well, yes. It seemed to me sexually...
Oh, please. Yeah, that. Yeah, you're always saying she's such a good play.
Yeah, what happens in the sack?
Complete psychic impotence. I'm dead when I always cry.
Say, Harding, wouldn't it be a lot easier if you were to just come and admit you're a faggot?
Mr. McMurphy.
Hey, leave the guy alone.
Sit down.
Hey, buddy, you don't have to take this shit.
Doctor, I think we should close the meeting.
Oh?
Close it until discipline has improved.
Say, buddy, is this how these little meetings usually go? A bunch of chickens at a pecking party?
Oh, a pecking party? I haven't the faintest notion what you're talking about.
Oh, no? Well, let me just explain it to you then. You see, the flock gets sight of a speck of blood on some chicken, see? And they all get to pecking at it until there's nothing left of that bird except bones, blood, maybe some feathers. But in the fracas, some of the flock get spotted themselves. Then it's their turn. Huh?
A pecking party. That's certainly quite a pleasant analogy you've got there, my friend.
Well, that's exactly what this little meeting reminded me of, my friend.
And that makes me, the chicken with the spot of blood, a friend?
That's right, my friend. And you know who gets the peck, the first peck? That old nurse, that's who.
So it's as simple as that, as stupidly simple as that. You're on our board 6 hours and you've already simplified the work of Freud, Jung, and Maxwell Jones and summed it up into one simple analogy. It's a pecking party.
Look, buddy, I don't know anything about any Fred Jung and Hoosie Jones, bud, all right? I'm just talking about what went on in this crummy meeting and what that big nurse did to you.
Did to me?
Yeah, in spades.
My, this is incredible. You completely disregard the fact that everything she did was for my benefit.
Horse apples.
I had judged you to be more intelligent, my friend, but it's evident I've made a mistake.
Well, then hell with you, buddy.
Oh, yes. I've also noticed your primitive brutality. Psychopath with definite sadistic tendencies, probably motivated by unreasoning egomania, and those talents certainly qualify you as a therapist, my friend. Oh, yes. They render you quite capable of criticizing Miss Ratchet, although she's a highly regarded psychiatric nurse with 20 years' experience in the field, but you, with your talent, work subconscious miracles, soothe the aching id and heal the wounded superego. You could probably cure the whole world in 6 months, ladies and gentlemen, or your money back.
Yeah, so, are you telling me that working on this little meeting is doing you some kind of good?
Why else would we subject ourselves to it? Miss Ratchet may be a very strict lady, but she's not some kind of monster chicken pecking our eyes out.
Oh, no, buddy. She ain't pecking at your eyes. She's aiming right square at the family jewels.
Miss Ratchet?
Yeah.
Why, she's like a mother. Like a tender mother.
Don't give me that tender mother crap. She's a ball cutter.
from way back.
See here, my psychopathic sidekick. Miss Ratchet is a veritable angel of mercy, and why, everybody knows it. She's as unselfish as the wind, toiling thanklessly for the good of all. Day after day, 7 days a week, she has no life, no husband. All she has is her work, and everybody knows it. Do you think she enjoys being stern with us, asking us these questions and probing our subconscious till it hurts? No, my egomaniac buddy. She's dedicated. She desires nothing more than to see us walk out of here well-adjusted and capable once more of coping with life. So you're wrong, I assure you. Our Nurse Ratchet is the kindest, sweetest, most benevolent woman that I've ever. When the wolf is about. He doesn't challenge the wolf to combat. Mr. McMurphy, my friend, I'm not a chicken, I'm a rabbit. All of us here are rabbits. Billy, hop around here for Mr. McMurphy. Cheswick, show him how furry you are.
Shut your mouth.
Well, tell us, friend, what would you have us do?
Raise Jack! Tell him to go to hell or something.
Try it, buddy. She'll ship you right up to Disturb.
Or down to the shock shop. The witch?
Electroshock therapy, my friend. It's a device which combines the best features of the sleeping pill, the electric chair, and the torture rack.
You shitting me?
Hell no.
They strap you to a table, touch you on both sides of your forehead, and zap! Punishment and therapy in one shocking package. Chief Broom there, he's had 200 treatments.
Alright, well then, what about that little fart of a doctor, huh?
She requires his approval, but that's just a formality. He has 200 patients, a bleeding ulcer, and no desire to make waves. What's the matter, friend? Losing your revolutionary spirit?
What about all this Democratic ward stuff, huh? I mean, why don't you just take a vote?
Why don't we vote?
That the big nurse can't ask us any more questions?
She can't look at us in a certain way?
Can't send us to the shock shop.
Tell us, friend, what shall we vote?
Hell, anything! I mean, don't you see? You gotta do something just to show you still got balls? Yeah. You say the chief is scared? Huh? Shh. What about you guys, huh? I ain't never seen a scared a bunch of my whole life.
I'm not.
Yeah. Well, it's no skin off my ass, huh?
How true.
And I certainly wouldn't want some old fiend of a nurse after me with 3,000 volts.
Naturally.
So what the hell?
Oh, Mr. McMurphy. Welcome to the club.
All right. You say she can't do anything to us unless she gets our goat.
That's right.
Unless we make her crack up in some way, like we cuss her out, or we punch her in the nose or something.
You'd be safe as long as you kept your temper.
All right. Well, I got an idea. Okay. All right. You boys think you got the champ up in there? How's about you put some money
on what?
That I can get the best of her.
You're willing to make a wager on that?
I'll wager that I can put a burr in that nurse's butt within a week. That I can bug her so much that she comes apart in neat little scenes of hers just to show you guys she ain't unbeatable. 1 week, boys, and if I don't have her where she ain't ready to shit go blind, money's yours, eh? Oh, boy. All right. Who's got 10 bucks they want to lose, eh?
Mr. McMurphy, this deserves odds. $20 to your 10 that you can't do it.
Oh, okay. Well then. Step right up, ladies and gentlemen. It's just a spin of the wheel. It's a turn of the card, huh? It's 1 week, 7 days, battle of the century. R.P. McMurphy versus the big nurse to a knockout decision or draw. Hey, get your money now.
I bet $5.
$5 to the roadrunner.
Gentlemen, it is time for occupational therapy.
It's great.
Mr. McMurphy. Mr. McMurphy.
Yes, ma'am.
What was that activity?
Oh, we're just playing a little game, ma'am.
You sure it's not some form of gambling?
Why, no, ma'am. No, ma'am. Gambling hell. This is a short thing. Oh, easy money for old McMurphy.
On automatic pilot for the night. It's in the night. They do the things they want to us. Things too horrible for day. And if the night ain't long enough, they slow it down. Oh yes, Papa. That's a fact. They got fake time. They can speed up or slow down. I once seen 3 months go by in an hour. I once seen 3 days go by like this.
Oh, there you are, babies. Oh, I couldn't possibly lose you. Oh. Hey, Chief, it's sack time. Hey, what you doing there, Chief? Hey, what you doing? Holy Christ! So that's where you keep it, huh? There must be 10,000 pieces of gum under there. Hey, listen, we can do better than that. Juicy fruit, okay? There you go, Injun. Put a nice fresh taste in your mouth, huh? Hey, somebody's coming! Just hollered. You sure did jump. I thought somebody told me you was deaf. Oh, boy.
Finger marks and smooches.
Scuffs all over.
over the place.
Man, Big Nurse found out about this. She's gonna stand us for sure.
She gonna get us with that big brown bag, too.
And we ain't gonna beat her back?
Ain't go, bro.
First we gonna slug her with this can.
Get her down.
Then we gonna prize open her mouth.
And stuff the whole dang mess inside.
Then we gonna bring her to the bottom of the pot.
Horses ain't hungry. Jesus say, come sit down beside me and feed them some hay. Morning, boys. Oh, my horses ain't hungry. But Jesus say, so fare thee well, darling. I'm gone on my way.
Hey, what's a chance of me getting some toothpaste from old Grinders?
We don't open the cabin until 6:45.
Cabin, huh? That's where you keep it, huh?
That's right.
Now why do you suppose they lock up toothpaste? It ain't like it's dangerous.
Ward's policy, that's the reason.
Ward policy, huh? Yeah. Now why?
What are you supposed to be like if everyone had to brush their teeth every time they took the notion?
I think I understand. Ward policy is for them who can't brush after every meal.
Still don't get it.
No. I mean, what would it be like if people were just brushing their teeth whenever the spirit moved them?
Yeah.
Now, imagine this, a world where people are brushing their teeth at 6:30, 6:20, maybe even 6 o'clock in the morning. Oh.
Man, come on, Williams. We gotta get back to work.
Hey, what you got there?
What?
And that old bucket there, what's that?
So powerful.
Well, I generally use toothpaste, but, we'll talk about this ward policy shit later.
Horses ain't hungry, but she did say, come sit down beside me and feed them some food.
Hey, you! Hey, get up! You're not supposed to be around my useless town. Now get to work! Move!
Oh, parents don't like me. They say I'm too poor. They say I'm not worthy to enter your door. My living's my pleasure. My money's my own. And them that don't like it can leave me alone.
Good morning, Miss Ratchet. How's things on the outside?
Mr. McMurphy, you can't run around here in a towel.
Oh, towels against ward policy too, huh? Well, I'll just...
Stop! Don't you dare. You get in there and you put your clothes on this instant.
Oh, I can't do that, ma'am. A thief in the night has boosted my clothes.
Boosted? That outfit was to be picked up, to be laundered. Williams!
Mr. Warren had laundry duty.
Warren, come here. Can't you see this man has nothing on but a towel?
And my cap.
Well?
He got up to her.
Got up to her. You'll get this man's clothes this instant, Mr. Warren, or you'll spend the next 2 weeks in geriatrics cleaning bedpans.
Bye-bye.
And you, give it that towel at once.
Oh, certainly, ma'am.
I suggest you go get dressed.
Oh, certainly, ma'am. Delighted.
Oh. Oh. She took me to her parlor. She cooled me with a fan. She whispered in her mama's ear, I love that gambling man.
Haven't you anything better to do than stand around and gape? I want this place to spotless. Gentlemen, Pat, you better go get dressed.
I remember one Christmas, Pop, here at the hospital. It was right at midnight, and there was a big wind, and it blew open the door, whoosh! And standing there was a fat man, all dressed in red, with a big white beard and mustache. Ho, 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 he says. Like to stay, but I really must be getting along. Very tight schedule, you know. Well, the aides jumped him and pinned him down with their flashlights. Then they tranquilized him and sent him right on up to disturbed. They kept him 6 years, Papa. And when he got out, he was clean shaven and skinny as a pool.
I thought we might have a little discussion. Informal, you know, on the subject of patient McMurphy.
Where is McMurphy anyway?
I suggested that this would be a good time for his visit with Dr. Spivey. Now, we aren't going to make any decisions, you understand, but I just don't think he should be allowed to continue to upset all the other patients.
I ain't upset, neither am I.
Well, you may not realize you are, however.
Don't I? Right?
Oh, it's a charming note.
Oh, a real one!
Doctor, we have a meeting in progress.
Oh, sorry. Go right ahead.
Yes. We were discussing the subject of morale.
Well, that's exactly what we were talking about. And I made the suggestion. Or was it you?
Oh, hell no, Doc. That was your idea.
I suggested. But what would you think if we were to have a carnival?
A carnival?
Right here on the wharf. I mean, wouldn't it be fun? We could have games and booths and decorations. What do you think, man?
It's a great idea.
And not without therapeutics.
Hell yes, lots of therapeutics in a carnival.
Scaly could do his human bomb act.
Boom.
I could make a ring toss in occupational therapy.
Hey, I'd be happy to run a skill wheel. Step right up, ladies and gentlemen, a bonanza for a dime. A prize on every spin of the wheel. Hey.
Oh, fine.
Maybe I could sell things.
I'm rather good at palm reading. Fine. So what do you think this carnival? Right here on the wall.
Well, I agree that it does have certain therapeutic possibilities, but it should first be discussed in staff before a decision can be made. Wasn't that your intentions, Doctor?
Yes, of course. I just thought feeling out some of the patients, but a staff meeting. Oh.
Also, Doctor, I recommend that Mr. Murphy's request for a visitor, as he puts it, a twitch named Candy Star, be denied until he becomes more familiar with the rules in this ward.
Mr. McMurphy showed me his request in my office, and I figured, I mean, since he's been here a week already, I signed it.
I see. Very well. Billy Bibbit and his speech problem. When did you first discover that you had speech difficulties, Billy? When did you first study?
The very first word I said, I stuttered. Mama. and when I proposed to a girl, I said,
honey, you marry me.
Until she broke out laughing.
Your mother has spoken to me about this girl, Billy. She was quite obviously beneath you. Is it that which frightened you?
No.
Then what was the matter?
I was in love with her.
Let me quote from your mother, Billy. She was a designing little slut that only wanted to marry my Billy.
No. She was a lovely girl.
Hey, I got a little something to take up.
If you wish to speak, you must first be recognized.
You mean you don't know me?
I know you, but I don't recognize you.
Oh, say, you got a hell of a problem.
Would you like to discuss it?
Father, I wonder if we shouldn't discuss Mr. McMurphy.
In what respect?
I have observed a definite deterioration in discipline since his arrival. Perhaps another form of therapy?
What you got in mind? Hooking me up to your little battery charger?
For your own good, Randall.
Yeah, in a pig's gizzard.
I must say, nurse, I agree with Patient McMurphy. I find him quite lucid, quite in touch, and despite his past record, he has exhibited no tendencies toward violence, so I must conclude that electroshock therapy is not indicated.
Very well. If there's nothing further.
I got a little matter to take up.
Doctor, I think you should make Mr. Murphy aware that the purpose of these meetings is for therapy, and not that his petty little grievances of his.
Petty? Petty? Are you calling the World Series petty?
The World Series?
Yeah, Doc. The big games. They start this Friday. But we got this rule, see? We only watch TV time at night. Let's change it to afternoon.
For therapeutic reasons?
Yeah, therapeutic is all hell.
Or were you hoping to make bets on the games?
Yeah. Come on, guys, what do you say? I mean, you want to watch the games, huh, Jez?
Yeah, why not?
Yeah, come, Scam.
I don't know, Mac.
Mr. Scanlon, as I recall, you refused to eat for 3 days until we allowed you to turn the television set on at 6 instead of 6:30.
Well, man's got to see the news, don't he? God, they could have bombed us clear to hell. It'd be a week before we knew.
Are you saying there's anything therapeutic about the news?
Well, maybe they won't bomb us this week.
Atta boy, huh? All right, all those in favor of changing TV time to afternoon, raise your hands. Alrighty. What is? Hey, Doc, I thought we could vote on these kind of things, right? Well, what is this crap? Hey, you want to watch those games, don't you? Come on, get your hands on the food. Come on, get your hands on the food.
3, Mr. McMurphy. Only 3. Not sufficient to change ward policy. Now, if that's done, may we terminate the meeting?
Yeah, let's terminate the lousy meeting.
Listen. Some of us, they've been here a long time. Some of us, they've been here a long time after you've gone. A long time after the whole series is over. Don't you see? Don't you realize?
I don't understand. I don't understand it!
I mean,
Hardy, what's the matter with you, huh? All you guys, what are you scared of, huh? Oh. You're a bunch of gutless wonders. You know what I ought to do? I ought to leave you to her. I should bust out of here and nail the door shut behind me.
All right. You're talking so big. Just how would you get out?
40 ways.
Name one.
Huh, you think I'm kidding, huh? All right. Look around here.
From the train.
This is a supply closet. that thing there, that thing Ruckley's always standing on. I could throw that through that nest window.
I don't recall anything about psychopaths being able to move mountains.
Are you saying I can't lift that dinky thing?
That dinky thing weighs a quarter ton, and it contains all of the electrical equipment for the station.
Hell yes, try it, Mac. You'll short circuit the controls and blow this whole damn hospital into orbit.
All right. Who's willing to lay $5, huh?
This is crazier than your bet against the big nurse.
Really? $5, you peckerheads? Because ain't nobody gonna tell me I can't do a thing until I try. Oh, hey, even better than that, huh? All your IOUs from blackjack, huh? Huh? Look, double or nothing, huh?
You're on.
Yeah, all right. All right, well, they take it. Help me get Ruckley down.
I got it.
Come on, boys. Mr. Ruckley, if you would, your services are no longer needed. And nothing to say today. Hey, Mr. Martini, would you and your friend kindly move out of the way?
Come stand back.
Yeah, stand back, guys, stand back. Yeah, scan them. Get the women and children to safety.
Come on, Mac.
Oh, Mac, you giving up?
Hell no. That was just a warm-up. Here comes the real one.
Come on, Mac.
Sounds like in the spring.
can smell the wind blowing off the peaks. I see a salmon jump. And there, the tribe, way out above the falls. Listen, how they yell every time they spear a fish. Making it come back.
All right, boys. Work time. Get going.
Farewell and adieu to you, Spanish ladies. Farewell and adieu to the ladies of Spain. We've received orders to spend. Hope in a short time to see you again. Farewell and adieu to your beautiful Spanish ladies. Farewell.
Mr. McMurphy? Mr. McMurphy?
Yes, ma'am.
Step out here, please.
Ma'am. She must have had to go real bad.
McMurphy, that is an outrage.
No, ma'am, that is a latrine.
You were supposed to get those fixtures clean.
Well, they may not be clean enough for some people. But as for me, I was planning to piss in them. Not eat lunch out of them.
I think we'd better get you another job.
Hey, take over for me, will you? Oh, the spirit that moves its flavor on the bedpost overnight. When you chew it in the morning, will it be too hard to fight?
There's a chair, Mr. McMurphy.
McMurphy?
Candy baby!
Identify your visitor, please.
She's my goddamn mother. Hey, boys, this is Candy Star.
Hi, boys. How's every little thing? Hey, Pop, what they got you in for?
Rape?
That's okay, baby. That's okay. Hey. This here's Billy Bibbit. Could you believe it? He's a virgin.
Aw, they locked you up for that.
Hey, come here, honey. Hey, sit down. Hey, come talk to me. Oh, man, how's the old gang? How's everybody? Hey, how's old Sandra, huh?
Tied up, man. I mean, like, really. She got married.
She got which?
Can you picture that? Old Sandy married?
Woo! Wait, who to?
You remember Artie from Beaverton? Always used to show up at parties with some weird thing, like a white rat or a gopher snake or some weird thing like that. Jesus, a real maniac!
Don't worry about it, honey. They're much crazy on the outside.
Oh, you damn it.
Mr. McMurphy.
Okay!
You all right, baby? I mean, they treating you all right?
Yeah. The grub, sensational. And the bed they give a man. Well, why don't I just show you, huh?
Why not?
Mr. McMurphy.
Okay! Okay. Here? Huh? Oh, yeah. Here? I'm pretty sure she wants to watch. Hey, you know, talking about all the old gang, all the old parties, it got me thinking. I bet I can arrange them if we throw something like that right here.
You kidding?
Oh, heck no, man. Hey, maybe you can ask old Sandra to come along.
I told you, old Sandy got married.
Yeah, but she still digs parties, doesn't she?
I mean, sure. Yeah. But how do we get in?
You leave that to old man Murphy.
Far out!
Oh, yeah.
Mr. Murphy, I'm afraid you'll have to ask your visitor to leave.
But I just got here!
It's okay, baby. Later. Look, go say so long to the fellas, huh?
Oh, you did. Later, boys.
Nice girl. Comes from a good family.
you're not really gonna do it.
Why not?
A party here.
Yeah, that's the scam.
Wait, with cake. Candy?
Candy, yeah. Cute trick, huh? Yeah. I bet you could picture yourself bumping bellies with that, huh?
Really? Yeah. My friend, for pure audacity, that proposition wins the analyst Oscar.
Yeah. I plan to throw the biggest brawl that ever got flung in a loony bin.
Oh boy, we're gonna have a party.
Did he say we? You said we? Who said anything about we?
We're not invited?
Nope.
Why not?
Because I'm fed up with you jerks, that's why. You know what's going on right this minute? And you, dickheads, kept me from seeing it.
But Matt, we tried.
No. I know, you did, Chez, and you, Stan. But the rest of them, too damn scared to raise their hands.
I'm sorry, Matt, if the matter weren't already closed.
Oh, is there anything in your rules that say, we can't open it up for another vote?
No, I don't believe that there is.
Well then?
Haven't you gentlemen work to do?
Yeah, sure, but right now we got a special meeting of the Patients Council.
It's called by whom?
By Mr. Dale Hardy, president.
That's right, Miss Ratchet.
For what reason?
For
the purposes of taking a revote on changing TV time to afternoon.
I see.
All right, boys, are you ready?
One moment, please. Have any of you gentlemen feel that Mr. McMurphy's imposing his own personal desires upon you? I've been thinking that you might be happier if he were moved to another ward.
You can't send him to disturb just for bringing up a vote.
Yeah, that's right, you can't.
Are you sure one more vote will satisfy you?
Listen, I just want to see once and for all, which of these birds has guts and which don't.
Very well. Everyone in favor of changing television time to the afternoon, raise your hands. One moment, please. The rules call for a unanimous vote.
Unanimous? Wait, you mean you want the chief to vote? So that's how you run this Democratic ward full of all the crappy...
You seem upset, Mr. McMurphy.
Yeah, just hold on 1 minute.
I'll have to make a note.
Just one lousy minute!
The meeting is closed.
Come on, chief. Come out here. Come on, chief. Come on. Come here, chief. Come on. Listen. Hey. Come here, listen. It's now or never, Chief. It's now or never. We make it, we break. We're minimum monkeys, Chief. Get that hand up and vote.
Don't be ridiculous. The man can't even hear you.
Come on, Chief. Just get that hand up, Chief. Get that hand up and vote now. Come on, Chief.
There's Ratchet.
Mac, look.
Unanimous! Come here, you gorgeous monster!
that a bad pitch. Oh my, the count out 3-2 at the time run on second base. Bottom of the sixth inning, hit the run situation. Here comes the windup. It's a...
Fix it.
Yes. Hey, what the hell? What the hell?
The meeting was closed. You men will now go back to your duties.
Back?
Do you hear me?
Sit down, Billy, sit down.
Do you hear me?
My blood is ragged. She's gone, Mac.
Yeah.
Yeah, all you need is enough.
knockout punch.
Yeah. Shut up, will you? Shut up. What she mean by that?
What, man?
All that years, Bip. Oh, come on. Why she act like she's holding aces?
Well, I guess it's because you're committed.
Yeah. Sure, I'm committed. But I only got 5 months to run my sentence, so. Oh, come on, give me the bit.
Mac, it's not like a jail sentence. In jail, you have a date ahead and you know you'll be set free, but here, if you're committed.
You mean I'm stuck here until she decides to turn me loose?
Whoo!
Boy! I got as much to lose bugging that old buzzard as you got.
More. I'm voluntary.
You witch.
I'm not committed. As a matter of fact, there aren't many on the ward who are.
You shit. You must be committed.
What?
Why? You're just a young kid. You should be out riding around a convertible, cruising for babies. Oh, ho, you guys. Why do you stay? You bitch and you moan. You complain about how you can't stand this place. You can't stand a big nurse. And all this time, you ain't committed? What's the matter with you? Ain't you got any guts?
Sure. That's it. We haven't got the guts. I can get out this afternoon if you think I want to stay here. I love a convertible and a girlfriend. Have you ever had people laughing at you? No, because you're so tough. Well, I'm not. Neither's Harvey, nor neither's Chester. And you talk like you say stated because
what's the use?
Alright, so why didn't you tell me?
What?
That she could keep me here till my dying day?
I guess it didn't occur to us.
That's a lot of crap. Oh, wait. Oh. Now I get it. Now I see why you guys keep coming at me like I'm Jesus to Christ. Huh? It's because I got everything to lose. And you guys got... Caught by a bunch of wackos! You bastards caught me!
Mac, believe me.
Oh, what the hell with that? And the hell with you? I got enough problems of my own without getting hooked up with yours. So just leave me alone. All of you, stop bugging me. All of you, stop bugging me.
Mr. McMurphy, what are you planning on doing with that?
I'm planning on using it, ma'am. I'm gonna scrub those urinals so clean, we're gonna need dark glasses every time we take a pee.
Mr. Harding?
Yes, Miss Ratchet?
Have you gentlemen been reasoning with Mr. McMurphy?
Yes, Miss Ratchet.
And exactly what did you say?
We explained the therapeutic community.
I see. That's fine, boys. That's just fine.
That means the pine that stands tallest on the mountain. My mother got twice his size.
He must have had a real moose of an old lady.
Oh, she wasn't big that way. She wasn't Indian either. She was a town boy. Her name was Bromden.
Oh, I think I got it. When a town woman, when she marries an Indian, that's marrying beneath her, ain't it? And your papa, he had to take her name.
She said she'd be married to no man with a name like T.R. Nulatuna. She wasn't the only one who made him little, though. Everybody worked on him, the way they're working on you.
They who?
The Combine. They wanted us to go live someplace else. They wanted to take away our falls. They found Papa in alleys, and they beat him, and they cut off his hair. Papa fought them a long time, till he was too little to fight anymore. Then he signed the papers.
What papers, Chief?
The ones that gave everything to the government. The village. The falls.
Yeah, I remember. But I was always told that the tribe got some huge amount.
Oh, yes. That's what the government guy said. Here's a whole big pot of money. And Papa said, what can you pay for the way a man lives? What can you pay for his right to be an Indian? He didn't understand. Neither did the tribe. They came to us, holding those checks, asking, what do we do now? But he couldn't tell them, because he was too little. And too drunk. What would happen to him, Chief? He kept drinking till he died. They found Papa in an alley and they threw dirt in his eyes. The combine whipped him. It beats everywhere. And it'll bust you out right. They work in ways. Ways you can't even see.
Hey.
They grab a hold of you.
Hey,
they install tunnels.
Hey.
Oh, and you try to fight back. Then they'll put you in some place.
Calm
and they'll make you
wait,
stop.
Come.
Hey. All right now. It's all right. I've been talking crazy. Well, yeah. It don't make sense.
Well, let me ask to that.
You.
Yeah, it's Canada Hawkers, Chief, flying south for winter. It looks like it's gonna be an early winter this year. Look. There they go, right across the moon.
Wire, briar, limber, long.
Hey, what was that?
It's a old nursery rhyme. My grandmama taught it to me.
Yeah, I remember that. You played on your fingers, right? Here, come here, Chief. Put out your hand. Yeah, that's it.
Wire, briar, limber, lock. Three geese in a flock.
One flew east.
One flew west.
One flew over the cuckoo's nest.
O-U-T spells out.
And a goose swoops down and plucks you out.
McMurphy, you gonna crawfish? I mean, are you gonna back down?
What difference does it make?
Well, are you?
Hey, you remember when I tried to lift this thing? I bet you could do it.
No, I'm too little.
Ah, why don't you give it a try?
I'm not big enough.
Oh, come on, Chief, there's only one way to find out. Hey, it's all right. Listen, if you change your mind, though, at least let me make book on it. Buddy, I'd make a killing.
McMurphy. Make me big again.
Hell, Chief. It looks to me like you growed half a foot already.
How can I be big if you're not? How can anybody?
Mm-hmm. meeting. Patience council meeting.
Play it at 3 o'clock.
Martini.
Knock it off. There's nobody there.
Don't you see him?
There's nobody there, I tell you. So stop it. Don't you see him? There's nobody there.
Given a great deal of thought to what I'm about to say. I've talked it over with staff, and we've all come to the same conclusion, that there should be some form of punishment for yesterday's unspeakable behavior. Now, most of you are here because you cannot adjust to the outside world. You broke the rules of society. And at some point, perhaps in your childhood, you were allowed to get away with that. But when you broke a rule, you knew it. And you wanted the punishment. You needed it. But that punishment did not come. Now that leniency on the part of your parents may very well be the germ of your illness today. I remind you this, hoping that you will understand that it is entirely for your own good that we enforce discipline. Is there any comment? Then I assume you understand and agree with me. You understand also that it's very difficult to enforce discipline in these surroundings. After all, what can we do to you? We can't arrest you. We can't put you in an institution. You're already there.
That's true.
All we can do is take away privileges. And so, after carefully considering the circumstances, we've decided to take away certain privileges that allowed, encouraged yesterday's rebellion to happen. First, for 30 days, there will be no viewing of television. Second, the privilege of playing cards during recreation time is hereby rescinded.
Is that all?
Not quite. There is one more matter. The behavior of a patient who's been here almost as long as I, longer, I'm sure, than any of you. I'm sure you know to whom I refer. Mr. Bromden was long ago diagnosed as catatonic. And for that reason, because we thought we could not communicate with him, we gave him up. We forgot poor Mr. Bromden. That was wrong of us. But Mr. Bromden behaved wrongly too. Now please understand, we are very happy to know that he can be reached. And we're very disappointed to learn that he would conceal it from us, thereby refusing to cooperate in his own cure. And if Mr. Bromden can speak, here, isn't it logical to assume that he can speak? I think Mr. Bromden should speak to us, don't you? His first contribution to group therapy. And how appropriate if those first words were an apology. An apology that made yesterday's rebellious...
McMurphy!
Mr. McMurphy!
I'll land you back at the floor!
You leave alone!
Mr. Murphy, I'm warning you, Mr. McMurphy.
Oh, yeah! Come on, you bastard! I've been waiting for this! Come on, stand up and...
Oh, come on, Chief. Why ain't you laughing right out loud? You gotta laugh, especially when things ain't funny. Come on. There you go. That's how you stay in balance, see? Yeah, hey, you know what? Look at you, huh? I think you're getting bigger right now. Uh-huh. Look at that foot, huh? That foot! It's the size of a flat car, huh? Hey, you keep going like that, they'll have no choice but to spring you, huh? They can't hold you. Oh, and then they'll come, Big Chief Bromden, huh? Stomping down the boulevard. Oh, men, women, and children, rocking back in their heels, going, ooh, who is that big monster? Oh, ducking for telephone wires, taking 10 foot at a step. Oh, pausing only long enough for virgins. Oh, the rest of you twitches don't even bother lining up. Oh, God.
Oh. What's so amusing?
Oh, I ain't sure you get the point, so.
Aren't you boys sorry for what you did?
I don't suppose so. So, whatever you're gonna do, go ahead and do it.
We had a meeting, Randall. The staff and I decided it would be beneficial if you were to receive shock therapy. Yeah. But we won't if you're willing to admit your mistakes.
Well, you got a little paper I can sign? Yeah.
A paper?
Yeah, that way you can put whatever you want on it later. How, like I'm part of a plot to overthrow the government, or how I think life on your ward is the sweetest fucking thing this side of Hawaii.
Randall, we are trying to help.
That bullshit! Yeah, what you gonna do, split my pants, shave my head, huh? Yeah, hey, don't worry, Chief. Chief, don't worry. Hey, I'll go first, all right? I'll go first. I'll go first. They can't hurt me. They can't hurt you, all right? What is that?
Conductor.
Anointus my head with conductor. You need help? Look! Do I get a crown of thorns too? Hey, don't holler, Chief. Don't holler. Or if you gotta holler, make it something like Guts Ball.
Oh, Guts Ball.
Yeah, that engine. Oh, look, I do get a crown. All right. Wire, Briar, Limberlock, three geese in a flock. Woof, please. Woof, through, woof.
Monte Carlo here on the ward. How much did you lose, Billy? Mr. Harding? I'm sure you all have some idea of what your losses were, but do you know how much Mr. McMurphy's winnings come to? According to the bank deposits, almost $300. I just didn't want there to be any delusions about his motives.
Well, he never made any pretense about his motives.
Yeah, that's right, he didn't.
Said he was gonna take us, and by God, he done it.
So there's no need to do any, cutting.
There's no cutting involved.
Oh, besides, it wouldn't do you any good. I got another pair at home.
Cases of uncontrollable violence.
He has exhibited violence.
Well, shall we say there was a certain provocation. No, Nurse Ratchet, and since you brought the subject in group instead of staff, I'll state my opinion. I do not approve surgical procedure in the absence of recurrent violence.
And if it should recur?
Then we may reconsider. Mr. McMurphy? But bear that in mind.
Aye, aye, Doc.
Behave yourself, boys.
Oh, ma'am, do reconsider your little treatments, please. I just love your little battery charger. Hey, what you mean by all that surgical procedure stuff?
Well, I guess you mean phlebotomy.
All right, well, what's that?
Call it kind of a castration of the brain.
All right, so what's it do to you?
They say he used to be a real rough character.
Ruckley?
Look, Mac, we've been talking it over, the boys and I, and we think you ought to get out of here.
Get out of here?
Yeah, Mac, we figured it out. Right after it gets dark tonight, I'm gonna set my mattress on fire. The fire department's gonna come, they're gonna leave the door open, and you can escape.
Boys, boys, that's as good as a TV show. And hey, I thank you for it. I thank you for it. I really do. But if I went, I'd miss the party.
And party?
Yeah, you've forgotten, huh?
Holy cow!
That's right. And you wouldn't want me to miss out on old Billy cashing in his virginity.
But Matt.
Hey, listen. Tonight, that window's gonna be open. And I'll just be able to sashay right on out of it, okay? So, why don't we just consider this a going away party, huh? Yeah? All right.
Supper time, gentlemen. Who have you feet?
It's Meatloaf. You love Meatloaf.
Psst, Bill. Meatloaf can wait. Come here, Bill.
But it's Meatloaf.
Shh. Hey, listen. Have you been taking your vitamins? Because I'm warning you, that candy girl.
Come on,
Matt. Hey. Don't go getting bashful on me now, huh? Hey. Because I'm betting that you burn that woman down.
that's right.
That's what I'm...
You're going to
burn.
Yep.
Burn. Did you hear this? Burn that woman down!
Yeah. There you go.
Hey, you got any bread?
Yeah.
How much? About $50.
$50?
Yeah.
What for?
Well, candy's laying out for liquor, and then we got old turkey to take care of, and... Oh, come on. Why are you looking down at me like that?
Something Miss Ratchet said.
What'd she say?
Something about how you were always winning things. Always... Coming out ahead.
Yeah. Winning, right? Oh boy, I'm always winning. Yeah. Winning. Hey, come on, Turkey, what's the beef?
Ain't no beef.
All right, so?
No money change hands, nigga.
They begged, borrowed, and stole.
You know, if they find out about this, they can fire my ass.
She's bringing liquor, Turkey.
Yeah?
Yeah. One bottle of scotch and one of gin. Which one you want?
I say sort of like, both of them.
Well, what are we supposed to drink?
You ain't supposed to drink at all.
Hey, any sign?
No sign.
Oh, I'm so stupid. How is she supposed to find the right window when they're all in the dark? Hey, turn on the lights.
Hey now, that's dangerous. Miss Ratchet, she's the ward litter.
She's asleep, Turkey.
That old shit pole never sleeps.
Where's the party?
It's in there.
Oh.
Hey, ready for the party. Hey, give me the keys.
I ain't supposed to give these keys to nobody.
Give me the keys.
It better be good liquor.
Open the window.
She walks in beauty.
Well, let her in. Let this mad stud at her.
No, listen to me, McMurphy.
Don't you mama Murphy mean belly, boy. It's too late to back down now.
Oh, you can't, McMurphy.
Candy!
Hey, what the hell?
Hey, don't worry about it, baby. Don't worry about it. Hey. Well, what happened to this one?
We got the rest of it right here.
What? We?
A Oh, Lordy, I forgot! Sandra's out there!
Hiya, Mac!
Sandy, baby! Hey, what'd you do with your husband?
Oh, that creep! She's up and left him! Ain't that a hoot? Listen, you can take just so many bungees like ants in your panties and rope down your bra. Jesus, what a creep! Hello, Billy.
Hey. I can't.
Never mind. Ouch!
You okay, baby?
Somebody pinched my ass.
I gotta find something else for us to drink. Hey, Chess. Hey, go find us something to mix this in, huh?
Wait, I got it.
Okay.
Holy candy girl! Is this for real? Are we really in an insane asylum? Hey! Tell me! Are you nuts?
Absolutely, madam. We are Psychoceramics, the cracked pots of humanity. Would you like me to decipher our workshop? Artificial coloring, citric acid, 60% inert material.
Yeah. 22% alcohol. Pour it in. Oh, baby.
10% codeine. Warning, maybe habit forming.
There's nothing like starting a good, bad habit. And she goes.
Tincture of Nux Vomica?
Nux Vomica. That'll give it body. Oh, yeah. To your health, gentlemen. Maybe if we cut it a little bit. There we go. Okay. That should be better. All right. There you go. Oh, bars open, gentlemen.
No, ma'am. The whole thing is a collaboration between Franz Kafka and Mark Twain. Interesting.
Tastes like golf syrup. Excuse me. I got a tinkle.
You know, this stuff gives one the feeling of...
No more rabbits.
Oh, friend, you told me that mental illness can have the aspect of power. Perhaps the more insane a man is, the more powerful he can become.
Sure, Hitler.
Fuck him all!
How about the seclusion room?
The place is one giant rat race!
One moment. Shall we send them off without benefit of ceremony? Come, my children. Here before me. Mac, would you bring Reckley? We need a centerpiece. We are gathered here in the sight of Troy to cheer on the end of innocence and to celebrate its demise. Who stands sponsor for the Benedict?
R.P. McMurphy.
And for the bride?
Excuse me. Me.
Very well. Do you, Candy Star, take this man to love and cherish for such brief time as rules and regulations may allow?
I do.
And do you, Billy Vivid, take this woman to have and to hold until the night shift changes an hour of his end?
I do.
He does.
Most merciful God, we ask that you accept these two into your kingdom with your most well-known compassion and leave the door ajar for the rest of us, for this may be our final fling, and we are doomed henceforth to the terrible burden of sanity. As comes the dawn, we shall most assuredly be lined up against the wall and fired upon with bullets of Paxil, Prozac, Thorazine. Go, my children, and sin while being made, for tomorrow we shall be tranquilized.
Hey, girl.
Mr. Ruckley, you did a fine job. On your feet, big baby. Oh, mama. All right. Back on your perch, canary. Listen, I've been thinking about that, huh? Why don't y'all come with me?
Oh, I'll be going soon, but I gotta do it my way, you know. Sign the papers, call my wife, tell her to pick me up at a certain time. You understand?
Yeah, but what is it with you guys anyway, huh?
You mean what drove us here in the first place?
Yeah.
I don't know, there's a lot of theories, but I do know what drives people like you. Strong people, crazy.
Okay, what?
People like us.
Bull.
Oh yes, my friend.
Hey, what's happening to the party here, huh? What's happening to the party? Hey, the Big Mac's tended bar, and when he pours, let no man... Chief, that you?
I guess so.
Well, what you doing, declaring war?
Well, my tribe never declared war on nobody.
That's my sorry damn tribe.
Maybe that was our fault. We should've.
What the fuck? Yeah, Chief. Yeah.
She's gonna get help, Mac. You've gotta get out of here.
Yeah. As soon as I say goodbye to all my buddies.
In a hurry.
You're the best damn buddies I ever had, huh?
I don't know about him. I'm a dragon.
Oh.
don't hang around.
Hey, what about you, huh? What about you? You gonna be okay? Cause if not, I'll hear about it and I'll come busting back
in. Come on, Mac!
Yeah, yeah, okay, I'm coming.
Stand still, everyone. Just remain right where you are. Warren, room check. Williams, get this place in order. Yeah, we've had a little party, have we? Oh, no doubt by Mr. McMurphy. I wonder, was there any profit to be made in it?
Oh, yeah. Real smart, lady. Trying to bug me till I bull, huh? Well, you can shove it, because I'm here!
Where were they?
Seclusion room. On the floor.
William did it. I am so ashamed.
Well, I'm not.
This?
Like what?
Low and cheap and pain.
She is not!
She's good and sweet and everything you remember.
Do to your poor mother? She's always been so proud of your decency. You know what this is going to do to her, don't you? You know, Billy.
No!
No, please, Miss Fletcher, please.
Don't tell her.
No, please,
how can I not, Billy? Please. I have to tell her that you were found on the seclusion floor of this cross.
I did it.
She made me do it.
I can't believe she pulled you in there forcibly.
No, it was the others. They made fun of me. They called me ugly names.
Who, Billy? Who, Billy?
McMurphy. It was McMurphy.
Billy. All right. Listen, I need you to go to Dr. Spivey's office. You're going to be needing attention. I want you to wait for him there, okay?
No, tell my mother.
Nobody's going to hurt you, Billy, and it's going to be okay. Everything's going to be all right.
No. Please,
take off. Huh? And you, miss, if you are not out of here in 10 seconds, I will have you arrested as a common prostitute.
You coming back?
Well, aren't you? There's no reason to stay here, Mr. McMurphy. You've already plundered these poor, sick people out of everything that they have. So run, Mr. McMurphy. Save your own skin. Get out by the gates. Because there's no more profit to be made off of these poor, sick, mentally ill.
Nurse Ratchet! Oh my God, Nurse Ratchet!
Nobody's blaming you, Mac.
That's right. No, nobody's blaming you.
His throat. He went in the doctor's desk, he found an instrument, and he cut his throat. That young boy has killed himself. He is in the doctor's chair right now with his throat cut. Oh, help yourselves by playing with human lives. Gambling with human lives as though you were God. Are you God, Mr. McMurphy?
our God.
No, Mac, it's what she wants.
Don't you think I know it?
Come on, Mr. McMurphy. Mr. Strong. Mr. Masculine.
They got to me again, Papa. They're putting wires on my head, and they're giving orders. Go right, go left, do this, do that. Sign the papers 20 times and don't step on the grass. Where can I run? How can I get away? No more places to hide, Papa. Nowhere to hide!
Well, pay some mind.
Gosh, if we only knew where they got them, what they doing, damn near a whole week now.
Yeah, I was in the dining room and this guy told me that Mac beat up two aides, he stole their keys and he escaped.
That sounds like Mac. And what war was your informant from?
Disturbed.
I heard they caught Mac and took him back to the work farm.
From whom?
Somebody.
Down in occupational therapy told me that McMurphy had sprouted wings and was last seen circling overhead, defecating on the hospital.
Honest?
Isn't it past your bedtime?
Miss Ratchet, what we want to know is when and
is
where...
Is McMurphy coming back? I think we have a right.
I agree, Mr. Harding. Mr. McMurphy will be returning. Oh, don't you believe me?
Lady, we think you are full of bull.
I can assure you that Mr. McMurphy will be returning. Now I think it's time that you are in bed. Bring him out, please. That's fine, boys. That's just fine.
What's it say? McMurphy, Randall Patrick, post-operative prefrontal lobotomy.
So they done it.
That ain't Mac.
No?
No, that's some dummy they rigged up.
You think so?
Yeah, factory made.
I bet he's right.
They did a pretty fair job though, see? Even the busted nose.
Yeah, but they can do noses.
Look, its eyes is open.
They're all smoked over.
Nobody inside.
How stupid does that old bitch think we are?
I wish McMurphy would come back.
Remember that time that he pinched Miss Ratchet's ass and he said he was just trying to stay in touch?
All those things he'd write in the logbook. Madam, do you wear a B cup or a C cup or any old cup at all?
Hey, remember the time that little nurse?
The one that wears a cross?
Yeah, she dropped the pill down her dress and she tried to get it out and he tried to help her and she started yelling.
Don't touch me, I'm a Catholic!
What the hell is going on in here? Oh, they come in cackling like a pack of geese. How's a man ever supposed to get any sleep around here? Chief. Chief, what are you doing? Let go. Chief, let go! Oh, no.
I've still got the keys to you. Okay, Chief, get going. Chief, do you hear me? If you're gone, they can't prove anything. Anyone can die post-operative. It happens all the time, but the big nurse, she'll look at you, she'll ask questions, and you'll talk.
What should I do?
Beat it!
Out there?
Flag a ride on the highway, head north, Canada. We'll say he was alive after you busted out.
I'm afraid. Chief. I'm not big enough.
You're as big as you're gonna get.
No. McMurphy said it. He says.
Chief, what are you doing? McMurphy says!
Out there. Yeah. I've been away.